And we open our eyes to a morning sunlight, and I go, damn it, vanquish the night. Fuck you, son! God
Why
damn it.
Am I awake now?
I don't get it. Yeah,
it's, yeah, like, it's gotten a little easier. We're pushing ourselves, but it's gotten easier.
Yeah, it's like...
Well, it's only been a week, so to a degree.
It's like playing I Wanna Be the Guy. It's going to get easier a little bit, and then...
And then huge disappointment.
Yeah, when Ryu has his revenge. Whoa! Sepia tone. Flashback! No.
With a coffee cream swipe? I don't know.
Wait, it says...
And re-swipe again!
Wait, it said... E-I in the coffee. Coffee's never wrong. It says Christmas. Isn't that right?
I'll admit, it's almost comforting to know we're not the only school like this. Wouldn't you agree, Zach?
Indeed.
You know, it's funny. I've seen two people play that. One, obviously, being Spoony, who he thinks Zach is just the imaginary friend of...
Of York.
Agent York. While one other person I've been... watching, Alon Ray from YouTube. I barely watch his videos anymore because all he does is, like, stream videos of, like, first-person adventure games. When he originally played that one, he thinks that the player controlling York was Zach. But I haven't really seen the entire game.
That's usually the first thought that usually comes to mind.
So yeah, long story short, Rin once again owes 500 yen to Emmy.
Well, that's another lunch on Emmy. But then again, Emmy's kind of buying her lunches anyway, so in reality, Rin wins.
Wow. It's like, even if I win, she wins.
So it's like me when I bet against Adam that Corpse Party blood drive would not come out on my birthday.
Huh.
You know, she's kinda looks familiar.
Bit.
Oh.
Oh, the mole, that's right. Now it's all clicking in. No, in all seriousness, this is just Emmy's mother.
No, it's just Emmy 10 years later down the line.
Huh.
So, they pulled a Haruhi Suzumiya on us. Huh. I often, like, think about sunset.
A little bit. Which, speaking of changes from day to night, did you manage to catch the lunar eclipse?
No. I saw basically the moon as bright as a pearl, but I did not quite see that.
Ah, damn it.
I gave it a drink, though, so I imagine it should be pretty nice.
Yeah, I actually got to see a bit of it. Wow, that was blood red.
I only got to see it when it was basically a white pearl in the sky. But it was beautiful at night, though. I honestly wish that there was
indeed
a full moon
was.
Every night.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, there's a character that we'll be getting a little more comfortable with later on in somebody else's route.
Yep.
Right behind Emmy.
Right behind her. Meanwhile, in Osmongadayo, at the sports festival...
And, according to this, somebody won by 10 inches? Mm. I didn't know that.
Maybe it would make sense in slow time, but yeah.
Yeah. I wonder why. Hell. Again? Yeah, but...
Yeah.
That's gotta take a toll on it. On her.
Not just for the fact that it'd be any runner, but there's one thing that the nurse constantly needs to check Emmy for, and that's abrasions between her legs and, well, her amputee legs and the prosthetic legs.
Yeah. Which means that the nurse is going to have a heyday with her, probably by the end of the day. Nah. No. She's only into it because of one reason.
You know, because the way I see it, running is pretty much like the equivalent of NASCAR racing. Oh, look, they're making another left turn. Oh, look, they're making another left turn. Oh, look, they're making another left turn.
God damn it. So, even Emmy's doing it. No! And now she's got a devious grin on her face. And here we go.
Already thinking of the many running tortures she's gonna put Hisao through. That's the reason for the grin, I can only imagine.
And then by the end of it, he'll be a real cowboy. Da, 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 da. And again, the father. Probably not a good idea.
No. Oh, God damn it, work not now.
That's I know that feeling all too well, considering I like was at the last 2 or 3 weeks I've had at least one manager call me and say, can you come in? We don't have any people again because we didn't bother because the other people called in.
You know, it's funny. I noticed
Emmy at her imminent.
One of my fellow co-workers couldn't come in today claiming he was sick. Whether or not that's true, given what today was by the time we were recording this, it was National Coffee Day. Kind of makes you wonder.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Ooh. That's not good.
And Ren can spot it right away. She doesn't know how to approach this. She's still leaves you to do it.
Yeah. It's like, I've known her for the rest of pretty much when we first met. You only just met her. Why don't you ask her instead? I'm sure there will be no consequences.
Even though if Ren asked, she'd probably actually give a proper answer. And the only problem is whether Ren would understand the answer or not would be debatable.
Yeah.
Yeah, I showed up. Yeah, this is going to pay for your doctor bill. Not really.
Yeah, Hisao, what the hell's wrong with you? Keep up next time.
Yeah, doofus.
You had one job, Hisao.
One.
God damn it. Just one job. And you blew it.
Oh, man. I know that story all too well. I'm not. Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, that twitch looked kind of murderous.
Yeah, a bit. Better hope it's just a little bit of pain, because, you know, not to bring up anything, but Hisao did have a minor heart flutter the second time he started running, and guess what? It was just a bit more than just a heart flutter.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not saying Emmy. I'm just saying.
Maybe you should just take care of yourself. I'm just saying, you Emmy.
It's like the whole weight training and trying to lose weight. I mean, yes, you have to exercise in order to lose weight, but if you don't eat, you won't get any energy, and if you have no energy, you won't have the capabilities of losing weight.
Honestly, I'm surprised they didn't make a custom sprite for, you know, the coat being on.
That would have been something.
Considering that they generally have some different sprites for other characters or different drawings. So. No, I won't. You know, somehow I kind of felt like I was talking to Honey Senpai from Boron.
Now you got that running through my head. Yay! Senpai noticed me!
No, actually, I was thinking of, what was it, when he had, like, the inner tube, and he goes, it looks good! And then it goes, and then everyone goes, wait a minute. On me! Oh. He's doing this on purpose! Though, I kind of made a comparison that the runaway guys are basically the Orange High Horse Club.
Yeah.
Chugga's Tamaki. John is
Kyoya. And I know what you're thinking. 13 minutes already? Why isn't the video over? Well, guess what? 13 minutes is way too short of a video, so we're going to keep moving a bit.
Yep. And let's see. Capri Sun? Oh, that's easy. he's Mori. Honestly, he kind of fits Mori, considering how quiet he is most of the time. And easygoing. So in that case, so how would that go? Would Misei be Haruhi then? That could kind of work, actually.
You never know.
Considering they do say she's a bit of a tomboy and she actually is more muscular than Chugga. Not to say that I'm inferring any, you know, shipping or anything, but, you know, she had seemed to fit the character pretty well. So, because I don't really care for that, sorry, this is real life, that doesn't work. That's not the only thing that she's rubbing off on me with. But then again, Ren's also rubbing off on me too. I started talking about clouds the other day. And then Misha was like, what the hell, y'all? Sound Jesus! Stop sniffing the paint!
Stop shrugging your shoulders like it's nothing!
But I don't know how else to respond. Ah, fuck!
That's still no good excuse, Sal! By the way, I know it's a bit too late to be asking this, but you want to join the student council? We really could use more members!
Preferably with those with arms and legs! Put them teeth! As Mother Shizune sits back in silent rage.
Indeed.
Yeah, a concern the fact that she has been running a bit better and a bit harder, but I think that might be against her regimen.
Yeah.
No, seriously, it's because you're friends.
Probably.
That's not the point.
Exactly.
That sounds like something Kendrick would say. That's not the point. Really, doesn't talk a lot. Considering that, well, yeah, to us, but then again, she's kind of in order to do that, but, you know, she's kind of taking the Nightingale treatment, as it were.
And take your medicine, goddammit!
Take my damn medicine!
Wow, it's like you put in Hoover Dam, barely touch it, and all of a sudden it breaks apart. I think that's all it takes to push Emmy to go into, oh my god, what have I done? I'm so sorry mode. I kind of have to side with the facial expression that Emmy was given there. Sniffing her hair for no reason.
Dude, considering how small that she is, relatively compared to Hisao, that's gonna happen. Eh. It's not like that he just, like, leaned his head over and started sniffing like a dog. We'll come in here anytime soon. Oh, sorry, was I interrupting? And fuck!
And thus the punchline has served its purpose.
Good night, take your damn medicine. Good night, sweet plants. Bye. Yeah, you bear swallowed them without a second thought.
Oh, damn, that wasn't his heart medicine. Damn you, Viagra! You're making the situation worse!
Actually, that I think would be part of the medications I'd be taking. Concerning that originally Viagra was meant to be meant as a supplement for blood flow to your heart. Well, it kinda was. Just had... It's just that when the poor bastard took it, realized he was kind of sporting a Johnson a little harder than he expected. Was a little hard to explain to the doctor. Then again, there was a story about the guy who took like a whole thing of Viagra and ended up with a hard-on for 5 days. Albeit he was sick during most of them.
Yeah.
Let's just say that I think anytime he had an erotic thought, he basically threw up. Then again, I think his wife felt pity for him. Like, but 5 days, that's gotta suck.
Yeah. I only have one pair of pants that I can use, and they're sweatpants.
You know, the most common pants if somebody works at going into a Walmart. Because, goddamn, I mean, we don't have, like, our ass, like, we don't have them extra tight. No, I mean. Oh, hi. Oh, hello.
Oh, hi, Emmy.
How's your sex life?
Damn it, I knew if I made that reference, that quote was going to be made.
Alright, let's go play some football, guys. I don't know how Ren's going to catch the ball, though.
Here, Ren, I got you some lunch. Let's go eat, huh?
Dude, you have a thing for her. Usually when you stare at a girl like that, that's usually a sign that... Now you're being creepy.
Well, you mentioned you look like a creep, so... Not too far off there.
Boobs. Surprisingly, this is actually relatively important.
I don't know. I think when I was in high school, I probably could have been pretty much anything I wanted, but
I wanted to be like a game reviewer. I wanted to do journalism and stuff. But then I realized, well, in the words of a very, very Lord Carrazzo, this world is corrupt. Or El Palazzo, yes, El Palazzo. A babbling brook, that's not used often.
Yeah, I think I've only heard that once before, and even then it didn't seem like it was the right time to use it. But maybe that was only because it was only the second time I've heard that term, babbling brook.
Pirate. So, are you planning to be a Gokai Ranger in the future, Emmy? That would be
awesome.
Oh,
no, I get it. She's just gonna get some program and illegally download videos of music. That's what she meant.
Wait, a pirate? She's gonna go Revy and Black Lagoon on this shit. That's terrifying. There will be many fucks said. So is Emmy gonna pull out like two Berettas out and just start shooting everyone?
Why would I not be surprised if she suddenly had the guns stored as part of her prosthetics?
I don't know, Bayonetta could do it, so why not?
Yeah.
Oh shit. And why weren't you staring at me?
Well, I'm sorry, Rin. If it was your path, I probably would have.
Oh, crap. What you been doing up there in the goddamn roof, you piece of shit? Speaking of which.
That's dangerous. Yeah, many sexual actions were taken on the roof. Huge injury occurrences go there.
I had to file a report with Zonton Hospital Enterprises. wait. Are you... I want you all to have a threesome! Just so long as I have the camera.
Uh-huh.
That'd be great. you're not exactly new now. It's been like...
Not it? Really. What is it, like...
A month?
2 weeks? A month?
Who
somewhere
knows?
In that timeline?
Thank you.
burn!
Shots off the port bow! Other Shizune is taking hits!
Okay, that doesn't... We were gonna go easy on you, but now we're sending all the sky pirates over to you!
I'm Omega Ripley, bitch! Can you shut the hell up? That's right, I will! Oh, yeah, I totally will. I think Rin was pointing out that you two coalesce or something like that. Dude.
Hisao, buddy! Concentrate!
Ah, shit. Speak of anti-concentration. Hey, we need to talk. How does everybody know about that?
Kenji has connections. That's all I know.
Wait, has Kenji been spying on us?
Oh, dear.
Either that, or he was actually trying to film a hentai himself. Unfortunately, nothing happened. He was rather disappointed.
Apparently, he has the looks and the stamina for it, but apparently the Harry Potter scarf is a bit of a turnoff for the ladies.
Dude, 500? I lent you 500 last time, you asshole!
And last time I checked, it was still 1,000! What an eccentric performance.
Oh. And this will play a decent part depending on which story or which route that you take.
Either way, it's always going to be from the same person.
Gee, I'm going to say Iwanaka.
Maybe.
Yeah, because... It's a beautiful letter, though.
Mm-hmm.
Sunflower. Gee. I'm thinking Hinawa. From Mother 3, of all things.
Hmm.
Now that's just a story of depression.
Who knows? Maybe, I'm trying to remember. What was her name from Samurai Champloo?
Fu?
Yeah, I was going to say Fu's father. You know, the samurai who smells of sunflower seeds.
I don't know. I watched that all the way, and... I gotta say this. That show is not as good as it thinks it is.
Yeah. Especially since it's a retelling of ancient Japan if it was told by hip gangster nowadays.
If I want that, I'd go play Yakuza. And guess what? Oddly, the Yakuza, from actual Yakuza, think that Yakuza the games are accurate.
Yes.
And then when I think about playing it, and I think about that, I just feel like a badass. Albeit they said they felt sorry for those who got Yakuza 3 and the stuff that they cut out in that game, and they more or less said that Sega USA sucks. Which, I was kind of afraid of when I got the fourth game, but apparently I heard the fourth game didn't really have any cut content, really. But... So then again, the fifth game, oddly, like, if you actually go to the arcade, you can actually play Virtual Fighter 2 there. Which I'm like, badass! I think I've had quite enough of this.
All this talk about Yakuza is making me envious that I don't have the game.
Damn it. Well, and then again, actually, the thing is that as Hisao goes through the routes, he actually does start picking up some of the traits of the women he's around. Mm-hmm. With Emmy in this case, it's running away from the problem.
And in a sense, you could say that the reason Hisao is here is because he has something physically wrong with his heart. In a sense, people think the name Katawa Shoujo for crippled girls means, oh, you have to fix the girl with their crippled problems. No, it's not necessarily that, but rather fixing what's wrong with their heart from an emotional standpoint.
Because, then again, the name Katawa Shoujo itself is kind of a tough sell and a half. Mm-hmm. Then again, the game's free, so...
Yeah.
Really, why would you complain?
Indeed.
Honestly, I'd like to see the game, like, show up on the PlayStation Vita. I can just imagine that work. I think oddly, when it comes to the kind of behaviors of, you know, kind of the emulation of characters, I think another game actually does it probably far more exceedingly well than Katawa Shoujo, and that's Yumi Mira Kusuri, actually. A drug that makes you dream. So it's roughly translated as. But the game actually has, you know, actual voice acting, so the sex elbow seems a little too real. So, but I think it's a pretty good game in its own right. Then again, the main character, I think, Kogami, I forget his name. Then again, generic, you know, male protagonist and such. His name actually quite literally means mirror. He actually does start taking on more of the traits of the three girls that he has the, you know, that he should be going after, or one of three. Because, then again, that game is even, how should I say this? When it comes to the decisions game, the game's decisions are actually very kind. Yumi Mira Kusuri gives you no hint of any indication that your decisions really actually had any effect until the end game. Which fucking sucks! Because especially when, no matter how the route proceeds, it's just based on those decisions, the endgame's determined by that. The route never actually has any changes, other than dialogue. Thus making it 50 times harder than it actually needs to be in order to get to the true end of that route. Mizuki's route was kind of a pain, especially when I had to do the route the first time. Yeah, she died. Resulting in me crying like a bitch. I'm like, did I do something wrong? Was there crap? And so I try to go back through all my decisions only to have her keep dying over and over again. And then I just go, fine, game facts. Wait, I was supposed to say yes to having her jerk me off? God damn it!
Oh, you know what? I finally realized it. One of the items in the bag was an apple, and God was like, oh, hell no, we're not doing this shit again.
And Izanami no Mikoto says, fuck you! Regrettable. We don't get to have food.
Incredibly regrettable.
Of regrettableness.
Regret.
And you think I'm joking about the decision in the game. That's actually a true one. That's the one that will actually determine the final in-game decision. Yeah. For just one of the girls. Just one.
one.
The other two are just as, how shall I say, bad in that regard. Albeit one actually does have quicker ends, so you at least have a kind of idea. But then again, the game's basis is based off of basically, let's see. One is basically more or less wrapped around social anxieties, the second one's around bullying, and the other one is around, well, I would say kind of drugs, really, but that's how you could sum it up, though. But I can recommend it, but for 18 and older. For 18 and fucking older! Now, if you're the some bitch who lets this kid play Call of Duty Black Ops, I will fucking punch you in the face.
That's the one thing that kind of pissed me off when I was working back at Target. There was a mother who had, like, an 8-year-old kid. Yeah. And she bought him an M-rated game.
Yeah.
And I'm... Of course... My job won't let me do it, so I just go for whatever. My mind, however, is just shaking my head in shame. It's like, this is the world we live in right now.
I mean, then again, to be fair, we all had our parents buy us M-rated games when we were younger. And again, to be fair, our M-rated games were kind of silly, to be fair and honest. So when do I get to Hoony Pop with you? Oddly, I think that is an actual outfit for one of the characters from that game. Oddly, in that game, as you actually unlock outfits for those girls, and you can actually have them wear what you prefer. And then the feminazis come out. But the thing is, the people that made that game actually made it with the intention of you trying to talk to women. You go confused. I think she just wants the same thing that Emmy does. She just needs a straw. Well, you need to grow a few pounds anyway.
Yes.
You're going to work it off anywho.
Yeah, I mean, technically speaking, even though you're out of shape, you're still thin. I'm sure you'd be nothing more than a toothpick if you didn't have at least something in your body.
I don't think some sugar would kill you, Hisao. On the other hand, having repeated consumptions of tea and cake, that will.
Yeah.
What?
If memory serves, isn't Hisao normally a coffee type of guy rather than tea?
Then again, we are at a tea shop, so...
Yeah.
So I guess we'll roll with that.
Yeah.
So... Though I had to laugh at this, though. At my GameStop, or the GameStop that I go to, they have a thing of what the employees are playing at the moment. I'm like, we could not run this in our Walmart because I think people would give me strange looks when they saw Senran Kagura 2 and Yakuza Dead Souls. While everyone else, Destiny, 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 Destiny. Sorry, people. Destiny is density. What? What'd you say, man? I think I have an idea what she said. I think she meant to say gay.
You know, technically she runs on the same team with Emmy, but at the same time, he runs for the other team. It's raining, right? Right?
It's cranberry or something. Well, I kind of guess you like strawberries. I smelled your hair.
Uh-huh.
Honestly, I don't think I want to do that work. If they told me, okay, so what games do you play? Steins Gate, Seven Carter 2, Yakuza and Dead Souls. I get some strange looks that day. And I'd never hear the end of it. Okay, what are you playing this week? Mega Man Legends? On my Vita? Which did come out today. For $10. Because Lord Capcom has... Oh god. They're doing a good. We must be in a mirror universe. That's all that can explain it. Yeah, she kind of did. Because she's a pirate.
Yeah.
This decision is rather... How should I put it? This one's... usually the better one is actually to just let Emmy be Emmy. Because she's like, okay, I'm just going to run anyway. I'm not sure if Rand is, though.
Remember that quote. Just remember that quote. Because I get the feeling in the next act it's going to play a heavy role.
So it's like Tamaki getting a cold in Oran High School Host Club, the manga? Which was actually a pretty big deal, because he never got sick. Ever. Are you stealing from the library, Kenji?
No, I'm just,
borrowing.
Yeah, borrowing. That's it. I'm borrowing these books.
And then I'm going to use them all to make my new doujinshi! I call it Harry Potter.
Hopefully some woman in Britain hasn't stolen my idea. In fact, I think instead I'm going to call him Kenji Potter. Trying to go Super Saiyan here, damn it! Why isn't it working?
I'm trying to go Crimson Mode! Fuck! And bam! They cut your nuts off. Fucking gone! I just imagine the neighbors across the hallway going, I feel sorry for that guy, you have to deal with Kenji.
If they had neighbors, yeah. As far as I can tell, I think for this floor in particular part of the building, it's just those two, but yeah.
I see a bunch of doors leaning overhead, so I'm going to say there's more likely more than a few people.
Eh.
Like, what the fuck?
Or story inconsistency. Either one of those two.
Then again, when it comes to visual novels, nobody exists except for the people starring them.
Yes. And they don't have a physical body and face, technically they don't exist.
They're just like a 2D cardboard cutout at best, if they're lucky enough.
Better yet, if they're not directly in front of you making body motions, they're not real. Much like Peter Griffin.
I agree. Because honestly, Peter Griffin does not exist to me. He's like Captain Archer of Enterprise. He's dead to me.
Mm-hmm. It used to mean something to me, but nowadays, no. It's just dead.
It's just dead to me. Well, I'll see you guys next time for the end of Act 2.
Yep.
Bye-bye.
See you then, folks.